in big chairs that used to be in these classrooms. This hall was not built when I walked around this playground and around this school, but I entered through the same gate that you entered every day. My mother had room 3, and that was my first stop off in the morning on the way to school. When the school bell rang, it was the same bell that you listened to. When we held assemblies, we had it in the choir. The library upstairs was the library I used. My roots are in this school. My mother was a teacher, but my mother also was a student here at Livingston. The blood of Livingston runs deep in all our veins. I was here as a child with big dreams. I sat on the side of the school, the Third Avenue side, and I read many books. And it was books that inspired me to dream and to dream big. I did not play sports because I had physical disability. I did not walk unaided as a young child. I only lived to walk after 3 major surgeries, which left me in a body cast from my ankle to my chest the last surgery. But at about age 6, I found my steps. I went to Rossview Central Primary School, just down the street. I grew up in Wineburg. But most important, I grew up with the understanding of education. My mother always told me that knowledge and the application of knowledge truly is power. Our school song that said, there's no world, no ocean too wide, or no mountain too high to scale, is so true. Because through that inspiration of who we are as Livingstonians, that carried me through many a dark moment on the high seas. I was part of the Pioneering Society. I was a part of the cultural movement of Livingston. In 1976, my family had to flee South Africa because my mother was a teacher who believed that education should be for all students, irrespective of race, color, creed, or sex. In 1980, in Standard 6, I was caught up in this very institution in the uprising, the Scythians. In my time at Livingston, we heard many a great speaker. And one day, the speaker who spoke about his adventures in Antarctica as a geologist. And I realized there was a huge world out there that I could be a part of. And made that choice. It was through reading, it was through dreaming. But it was through the love of the teachers of this institution who encouraged me, who encouraged every one of our students to advance and to be excellent at whatever we put our minds towards. I went on to become a commercial diver. I studied in California. I returned to South Africa and back to the institution to share some of my adventures as a diver. But my dream was to own a yacht. A dream that looked impossible. People said to me, you are black or you're colored. People said to me, you are disabled. Some people said to me, you're poor, you're a working class. Give up the dream. But at Livingston, we never accepted labels. We never accepted glass ceilings over our heads. At Livingston, we pushed the envelopes. I designed the boat of help. I built the boat of help. And I did that, again, because of books, public libraries. I used to walk up to Wineburg Public Library and find all kinds of books about the sea and apply that knowledge. As I said, I sat on the side on the side here around Third Avenue, and I read those books, and many students thought I was strange, I was different, I was weird. It's okay to be different. It is not okay not to gain a knowledge base. It is not okay not to dream and to dream big. It's not okay not to work incredibly hard. If you have those ingredients, the world will open to you. I built my boat at age 23, as I said, with help, and sailed away from Scientific Shores. I entered my first international yacht race in 1992, the solo race from England to America. I am a solo sailor, a solo racing sailor. I proudly carried Livingston with me on that voyage. I then returned to Europe and entered the 1994-1995 solo race around the world, 27,000 miles around this planet. And Cape Town was the first port of call. When I arrived back in South Africa, you, the reason was on the docks to welcome him. I only had a few days in port, and then I was just masted deep in the Southern Ocean and had dropped out of the race. And many people said I failed. There is no thing such as failure. Failure is when you give up. Failure is when you say, I will not try. I will not apply myself. We all face setbacks. It is the setbacks of life that sometimes we will learn the most from, because it will test our internal mettle of how much do you want success. In 1996, I entered the Oslo Yacht Race again. This time I was hit by a Russian freighter in the middle of the ocean, in North Atlantic. I spent 15 days pumping to keep that boat afloat, but I stayed racing and I finished. I finished third. In 1998, I re-entered the 27,000 mile race around the world. And once more I sailed back to Pale Bay. Once more, Livingston had his banner welcoming me back to this harbor, back to my roots. And again, I stood the quad, and as I address you, I address that generation of young leaders and young leaders. In 1999, I finished the solo race around the world. I became the fourth South African to race solo around the world. In history, the first black man to race solo around the world. But more important, I was the first Livingstonian to dream big of an ocean, and to go out there and tackle that ocean, and to prove that we can achieve anything we set our minds to. When I was raised here in Cape Town, in Wynberg, and at this school, my mother said, son, whatever you do in life, ask three powerful questions of yourself. And if you can in fact say yes to all three, life will be your best struggle. And 6 years ago, I had that fourth. That first question is, whatever you do, is it right for yourself? It doesn't matter what those dreams are. Make sure those are your dreams, your commitments. And say yes exactly. Then the next question is, whatever you do, is it right for your family? Again, make your family proud of who you are. Now, a drug dealer can also justify and say, what I'm doing is right. A wife for myself and a wife for my family. A drug dealer can say, look at a nice house or look at a nice cars. But that third question, what I do, is it right for my community? Today, we live in a global community. What happens here in Claremont has an impact in this country, South Africa. Has an impact in this world. Now the drug dealer cannot say yes. In no true honesty can someone who does something illegal, does something not for the better of mankind, say yes. So make sure that your actions are always going to be positive for your community. And that fourth question, 6 years ago I became a grandfather. My wife has a son, and he had a young child. And when I held his little baby girl in my arms, I had just come back from working in Bermuda with the Bermudian Premier, which is the equivalent of a Prime Minister, and the Bermudian Cabinet, and their Department of Education and Young People. And as I held this girl in my arm, shall be grace. I wondered what kind of legacy are we passing on to her and the future generations. So whatever you do, make sure it's not just right for yourself, your family, or your community. Make sure it is right for future generations. I am a product of a past generation. You are a product of the future generation. I went on and built my life in the United States and in the Caribbean. I have worked as an international businessman, as a global investor. I have worked as an international keynote speaker, addressing audiences all over the world, working with world leaders, not just in the political arena, but also in the economic arena. And I work with young people like yourselves. And I can tell you, there is an amazing world out there. And it's not the politicians who make our world great. But quite frankly, they do a lot of disruption to our world. It's people like yourselves. You are the future of this world. You are a part of this world. It is our young people, it is our citizens of the world who truly bring our world together and make our world go around. It's not about what you have. It's not about the material things. Yes, some of those things are important. To have a roof over your head, to have transportation, to have a meal every day, to have an incredible institution like Livingston and a school. Yes, these things are important. But it is more about who are you? What is in your soul? What is the fabric of who you as a human being are? It's not about what you have. It's about what shall be the gifts and the contributions that you will make to society. Our world functions on people. It functions on the collaboration of people. And it's through institutions like Livingston that you will gain a knowledge base. Build upon the knowledge base. South Africa has been a country which has gone through major changes. We were a country that was once enslaved. We are a country that fought for our political freedom. And again, Livingston was a central part of the political struggle. Don't forget who and what your roots are. But in 1994, when South Africa became an independent country from apartheid, our journey was not over. Our journey was just the beginning. The next stage of that journey is in your hands. We are going to have to go through a political evolution in South Africa. We have to go through an economic evolution in this country. The wealth still has to be spread. The ideas still have to be spread. We are a young democracy, and not a democracy in its fullest entity yet. We are emerging. Don't believe everything you read in the media. Don't believe everything a politician says. Question, challenge, look for yourself. There are no excuses why you cannot gain knowledge. Look at other countries and understand what has worked in those countries and what has not worked in those countries. And adopt the best practices, the best principles, but make sure you are driven by the guiding principles of who you are and what our country and our institutions truly are. We are also facing an environmental crisis in the world. We have now more and more people. Our planet cannot sustain the growth and the demands we are placing upon the planet. We have to now really look at how shall we evolve as mankind. I am here as ambassador to Global Women's Day. I am here as an ambassador for Livingston, as a South African, as an American, as a citizen of the world. We have to relook at our energy policies. Fossil fuel is going to run out. Coal and dirty coal is polluting our environment. We need wind generators. We need solar power, solar turbines, solar cells. We need to change how we do things. We cannot do the same things over and over, expecting a different result. We have to change. The one thing in life we are guaranteed is change. But we are the folks who get to embrace change, who get to drive change, who get to ensure that change will be good for all people. We are the Livingstonians. As I can walk in this institution, through the quads and through the rooms of this school, and eventually walk the walls of government and the walls of commerce, you so can too. The future of South Africa, the future of Cape Town, and the future of our world is in your hands. So please, give your best. Never stop dreaming. And never forget Livingston. No ocean is too wide and no mountain is too high. Always advance Livingston. Outlook Book Award in the United States. Someday, hopefully, this book might be a motion picture, and maybe someday that film might be filmed here at Livingston. But this is my story, and this is your project for your school library. So it's present on behalf of my wife and I, and in memory of everything that Livingston has done, and the gift my mother has given you, has given me, I pass on my photography to your own version, and I hope that someday you will write your photographies and share your journey of success.